Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to explain how you can calculate sum of digits of a number, right? So before starting, I want to share some details. So if you go to the details or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to various programming languages. So if you want to watch more programming related videos, so you can follow those playlists. Now I am going to start this. So first I'm going to explain the scenario, like what we are going to implement. So let's say we have a number 1, 2, 3, right? So now what we need to calculate, we need to calculate this 1 plus 2 plus 3. So we need to add each digit, those are available in this number separately, and then the final outcome will be the output. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equals to 6. So if we take input as 123, so its output should be 6. Now if we take input as 12, so its output will be 3. If we take number as 1, 2, 3, 4, so its output will be 10. So no matter how many digits are available in a number, the program should work for all numbers. So it should work for 1, 2, 3 as well, because it is 3-digit number. The program should work for this as well, because it is 2-digit number, then for it as well, because it is 4-digit number. So we need to separate each digit from that number, and then we need to add those digits so that we can find out the final outcome. So this is the mathematical explanation. Now I'm going to convert this calculation into C program. So here you can see I have declared three variables, N, S, and A. S is initially initialized with 0. Then I am writing printf. So printf will display the message, enter a number, and I am going to receive that number into a variable N. Now I'm going to apply a while loop so that we can implement this logic. So while condition is n greater than 0, and inside this loop I'm going to write three statements. So let me first write those, then I will be explaining how they are working. So first is this n modulus 10, then s equals to s plus a, then n equals to n by 10. And this way I completed this while loop. So now I'm going to explain this, how it is working. So let's take example of 123 first. Then I will be taking example of 12, and then you will automatically understand how 1, 2, 3, 4 will be calculated. So initially n is 123, value of s is 0. So let's check this condition, n is greater than 0, right? Now n modulus 10. So 123 modulus 10, so remainder will be 3. So whenever you divide any number with 10, so remainder will be always last digit of that number. So in this case, number was 123, we are dividing it by 10, so remainder will be 3 automatically, and we are storing that into A. Now I need to add this digit into S. So this is very simple. So S is currently 0, we are adding A, that is 3. So 3 plus 0 will become 3. So new value of s is now 3. Now calculate this, n divided by 10. So n is 123. If we divide 123 by 10, so result will be 12. Because if we divide any number with 10, let's say 123, so its result will be 12.3. And we are using integer as data type, so it will store only 12. So first rotation of loop is completed. Now we need to check the condition again. So right now n is 12. So 12 is greater than 0. It is true. Now check this. 12 modulus 10. So 12 modulus 10, remainder will be 2. And that will be stored inside A. Now see the current value of S, that is 3. Add A, that is 2. So 3 plus 2 will be 5. So 5 will be stored inside S. Then again we need to divide n by 10. So n is 12. So So next time it will be 1 only, because 12 by 10 will become 1.2, and we need to store only 1 because we are taking variables as of integer time. So second rotation is completed. Now again check the condition. So n is 1. So 1 is greater than 0. Then 1 modulus 10. So in case of modulus operation, if numerator is less than as compared to denominator, so final outcome will be numerator value as it is. So a will be having 1. Now s is 5 and we need to add a, that is 1. So 5 plus 1 will be 6. So new value of s will become 6 now. Now divide n by 10. So if we divide 1 by 10, so result will be 0 point something. So we need to store 0 into n. So third rotation is completed. Now check the condition. N is 0. So 0 greater than 0 is false. So this way you saw, if number is of 3 digit, so this loop will repeat 3 times only. If number is of 2 digit, this loop will repeat 2 times. If number is having 4 digits, so this loop will automatically repeat 4 times. So I hope now you can calculate the sum of these two values as well, because I explained you the complete rotation of this logic. So here this statement is important, which is calculating sum of individual digits. Now after completion of this loop, we can print value of s that is containing final outcome. So after completion of this loop, you can write printf sum equals to percent d comma s. So this way it will be printed, and then I am closing main function. So here you can see this loop is calculating sum of individual digits, and then after completion of this loop, we are printing value of s variable so that outcome can be displayed on output screen. So I hope you understood how I calculated logic first, and then how I implemented the program with the help of C. So if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist. So there are various programming related videos are available. So I have uploaded more than 1000 videos on my YouTube channel. So you can watch them and you can learn programming easily. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. Thank you for watching this video.